So yeah, we got the new luck unit. We haven't maxed him out yet. He's about halfway there. You see him at 59 luck. He goes up to 120, unfortunately, not 140. But he's pretty solid, to be honest. Granite has a lot of potential, I think, to be really good. And there's certain comps with him that I think actually perform a lot better than others. But you guys saw me grinding him in the intro. His grind isn't too bad at all, especially if you can nuke it. If you can't nuke it, it'd probably be really easy just to farm it in multiplayer if you really need him. But I don't think he's a must-have luck unit. He is pretty fun though. Also, if you're wondering, OP, why is he max level? Why is he already awoken? It's because this video has already been recorded. I know. Cardinal sin, as they say. I don't know why I'm like the way that I am, but to put it simple, I recorded an entire video for this guy already. It was like 20 minutes long, and I didn't click record on my Audacity, which is my commentary software. So y'all would have saw the gameplay, but you wouldn't be able to hear me talk. I guess I'll just be like every other GS YouTuber then. But either way, we're still gonna go through with it. We're gonna show him off again. We're gonna do everything that we usually do. Cause like I said, I don't think this showcase is gonna be long anyway. So it's not like it's gonna be that much work for me to redo everything. Not like the first time I had to do it either, because I've done this more than once, unfortunately. But real quick though, before we get any further in the video, I want to ask you all a question. Yep, you heard me right. If the last video that I asked you all a question was anything to go off of, so I'm gonna ask you guys another question today. But it's not gonna be channel related. Well, I guess it kind of is. It's gonna be video related. Would you guys like to see me play the new Konosuba game? Not talk about make content on it. I would just make like a video, probably playing it, seeing my first impressions about it, and whether or not if I like it or not. Now, let me just say too, I have no idea what Konosuba is, apart from it's an anime, and I think one of the main characters are named Aqua, and I only know that because of cosplayers I follow on Twitter. So yeah, I've never actually watched it or seen anything from the anime, but I heard from everyone that's played it, or a lot of people that are playing it, is like, oh my god, this is one of the best gacha games I've ever played, or the case may be. So there has to be something there. And it's not just like one person is saying that, like multiple people are saying it. So it's gotta have some type of fun aspect to it, right? Or is it just like that honeymoon phase that everybody's in? Either way, you guys let me know if I should play Konosuba or not. And the way how we're gonna do that is get this video to 600 likes. You heard me right. 600 likes within 24 hours. And we'll do a Konosuba video. Because really the only other mobile game that I'm looking out for right now is World Flipper. And I don't even know how much I'm going to enjoy that because it's like a pinball game. But it looks kind of cool to me and it's a little bit different. And also side games are behind it. Even though I don't think they're the ones that's going to be developing it on the global side. Either way though, it's a side games product. I do like me some side games. I love Dragalia, even though I didn't stick with it for long. Still is a really good game. If I had more time, I would be hardcore into Dragalia. But since we're talking about dragons, Grenna's story is actually pretty cool. The story revolves around him, of course, being a human and him getting some type of dragon curse, and he has to try to fight it off. That's like his whole end goal, I guess, is to conquer this curse and be able to control the power that he has now. And if you actually fight him in his event, you'll be able to tell this super easily, because as you're fighting him, the more and more like you're beating him and lower HP he's actually getting, he will start saying stuff like, my power is overflowing, or I can't control it, and stuff like that. And it's really cool. It's really dope. I haven't read all the compendium stuff yet. He's like a guy with endless amounts of dragon power and he's trying to control it. And yeah, it's pretty sick. I'm not gonna lie. As we do every time on this channel now, let's look at the animations. Even though I've already done this once, we'll just look at them because why not? You guys weren't here. Shing, shing, shing. His skill is, I think this is an ice blast, right? Yeah, it's just an ice blast. Very simple. It's not anything too crazy. I will say real quick though, does this weapon that he's using looks like the Keyblade from Kingdom Hearts 3 that I think was the Frozen World Keyblade? And then his art, ice storm everywhere. I guess you could even say a hellstorm at times. But yeah, it looks pretty nice. And then his true art, I really like, where he just instantly, boom, erupts like a huge, huge mountain of ice, shatters it with his sword, and then just flies back down. And whenever I was fighting him in his event, I actually thought he was flying through this block of ice, like he was doing that and then flew through it. And I thought that would be really cool, but he doesn't. He just, from what I can tell, he slices through it and flies back down. His kit is very simple. It's just like he's a freeze unit. He wants to freeze the enemy. He's able to lower the enemy's freeze resistance with his skill. He's able to give water allies more damage with his art. And then with his true art, he has a high chance of freezing the enemy. And if they get frozen, he increases the damage by 80%. So the team that we're actually going to be using today with him is going to be none other than... Wait, did I not make the team yet? But it's going to be showing him off in a nuke composition against Special EX Ganon. Hopefully he's still here. He is here. And this is what you're mainly going to be seeing the boy Granith in, because Granith is kind of a nuker to an extent. Not necessarily, but this is what I imagine that people will be doing whenever they max luck him. You won't really be seeing him in actual team comps. You'll be seeing him in like luck compositions. He's one of those older luck units where you can use him in just a regular team, but you probably will be using him majority of the time in multiplayer whenever you can get a freeze off and actually deal big damage to the boss. So for that exact example, we're going to be taking on Ganon, and we're going to be using this team with these equips right here. Unfortunately, I do not have Emilia max lucked. If ReZero ever comes back, I will be max lucking her because I just completely forgot about it. I thought I had her max luck, but I didn't. And then Melty, I need to make sure I at least get her max luck before the Shield Hero campaign ends, because her max luck is insane due to the amount of potential she has, especially with her true art, Jesus. But yeah, I've been seeing people already start running a team similar to this, where you run pretty much all luck units, everybody with 120 luck, you go into a fight and you just blow the man up and there's really nothing that he can do. As you see, we should get a freeze off, maybe? No freeze? Oh, never mind, we did get a freeze. And that's pretty much it. Of course, that was against Special EX, but that's mainly what you're going to be fighting with Granith. You're not going to be fighting harder content, even though you could use him as your main freeze unit. And I don't think Ifrit is here. If Ifrit was here, we would try to use him as the main freeze unit to see how well that would do. But let's see if Ifrit is here, if the giant boss Ifrit is here, or the Crest Palace Ifrit. And the giant boss Ifrit is actually here, but is the Crest Palace one here? Unfortunately, it is not. The only problem with this would be, of course, that the Ifrit boss fight himself isn't necessarily too difficult anymore, because a lot of units can just straight up kill him without even having to deal with his mechanic of freezing. And I think that maybe even the units that I'm going to be using in this fight, you'll be able to see that, because yeah, this is a pretty loaded team. Another thing that I have a problem with Granith is that his event is kind of trash in terms of the equipment it drops, because it doesn't drop you a freeze resist down equip, and it really should. Because new players getting into the game and they farm this luck unit, they really should have a freeze resist down equip instead of a 5-star defense equip, just because that's what Granith is going to be trying to do, and that's definitely what's going to be best in slot for Granith, is a freeze resist down equip compared to something like a 5-star defense that's kind of lackluster. Oh man, I'm tired. I just got back from Sleepy's house. I went to go celebrate with him and the boys because it was his 21st birthday, like 2 days ago, and yeah, it was all the boys getting together, and we haven't seen each other in so long, and it was a really nice time, not gonna lie, very nice. And not gonna lie, your boy is sleepy. I ate some Domino's pizza, man, and let me tell you, ooh lord, Domino's may not be the best to some people, but every time I eat it, I don't know what they put in that pizza, but it always makes me sleepy, and I have no idea why. But let's see if the boy Granith can actually freeze the enemy here, and does he get a freeze off? And he actually does. Wow. I wonder what's the actual chance for a high chance to freeze. Like, you know, what is the actual rate of that? So yeah, Granith, how are we feeling about him? Let me know down below in the comment section. I think he is a lucky unit that you kind of need to farm, because there will be an event in the future that you will need to freeze the boss in order to like really deal big damage. And if that's the case, you're definitely going to want a luck unit like Granith on your team, because if you don't have one and you need to freeze, it's going to be a little bit difficult. But if you have Granith, then he can kind of take care of that for you. Of course, I think he's also just good as a main freezing unit, especially if you don't have one. Like, he's definitely not the worst freezer in the world. He does have freeze resist down, so he has that going for him. Plus, he does have 100% crit rate as well whenever he's actually freezing an enemy, which is another plus. I wish he also had crit damage built in somewhere, like right here. He had like Fatal Blow level 3 or 4, something like that, just to give him even more damage potential. I'm going to stop talking. I'm going to let y'all go, because for one, your boy OP's tired. I need to go get some water. I need to go lay down and go to sleep. But yeah, Granith, cool unit. Make sure you guys farm him. And don't forget to tell me down below if I should try Konosuba for a video or not. Either way though, thank you guys for coming out. It's been your boy P. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe for more. And last but not least, you guys already know, don't forget to drink water.